Hello everyone, in this movie I will show you how to install another Android radio, again on BMW E60, sorry, I know I've done the movie like this before, but this will be slightly different. I will try to, let's say, show more than on the previous movie, because I had like plenty of comments where some people had some difficulties with following my instructions, so I will try to make this one more clear. Also, this is slightly different version of the Android radio. This one, it's more modern. It's Android 9.0, not 7.1. So it's quite modern. So it should also work in better way. Also, you got external microphone. In this car, it doesn't make much difference because this car have originally Bluetooth provided with it. So there is a microphone. I think it's here or somewhere there. So in this car, when you're speaking using the Bluetooth, other people can hear you very clearly. But what I've noticed is, like, on those radios, when you are using the microphones, which are, I think this is where microphone is located, because this is so deep into the car, people can hear you, like, if you are speaking with the through the pipe. So it's not the best sound quality. So in this movie, I will try to make installation clearer. Also, not for all the connectors. I will try to avoid going through the pillars because you got airbags over there. I do know that for some people this might be a problem, but the truth is that airbags are there, are literally everywhere, which means that it's really hard to put the cable avoiding any connections for the airbags. So in this case, the GPS I will point over there, so it's not gonna go through any of the pillars. Sadly, the microphone for Bluetooth will have to go through the pillars, so it will go over there, like on the top, and then will be installed here. But anyway, I hope this movie will be clearer than the previous one. In addition, the person that I'm installing this radio to wanted to have a camera, rear camera in the handle. The reason for it is that if you got camera in your registration plate lights, then those LEDs can give you error messages, and for some people it's annoying. And to be honest, I think I will even use this one for myself in the future as well. So we will see how this camera will perform. So anyway, the first step that you have to do, one more thing. When you're ordering your radio, make sure that you're ordering the current model, because you got CCC and CIC. So is the look which looks this way. So this is a small radio and this is all style, so it looks this way. This is a CCC. CIC is slightly wider and you got a more modern look, let's say. So this is a CCC, so just to make sure. Yeah, so this car is BMW 520 LCI, and this will be procedure how to do it. So the first thing which I will do will be to actually remove the screen. So there are two screws which you got pointed over here on the both ends, and this is the first step. So to remove the old screen, you are using tool T10. So now when you remove those two screws from here, you can pull out the radio. And to remove this connector is pretty simple. You're just pressing on the middle. There is like a wee thing to press. So when you press this, then this go above it, and it will allow you to disconnect it. With this one, it's slightly more complex. You see there is wee thing here, which is hanging out a little bit. And this is in this hole. So you have to push it and then pull it out. And this will allow you to disconnect this connector. Don't force it because you can break it and you don't want that. So first you have to put the wee screwdriver on the middle and then remove the connector. Now, using plastic tool, I would recommend to work from this end. Put the tool on the end, on the edge, then try to work this out gently, because with time this can seize. If there was, that was never moved, it can like glue to the other side. So just work gently, then try to move it on the bottom as well, then on the other edge, open the doors on the other edge, and this will allow you to release the middle part. So this will help you to release it. And then when you remove this part, there will be connector for those lights which you will have to disconnect. So when you remove this, then connector is located on the bottom. and this is just a matter of pulling it out. It's not easy by one hand, but yes, you see, this is just pulling it out. Try to pull it by grabbing by that. It's not easy. So the next step will be to remove those two screws, this one and that one. After those two screws are gone, you put in your plastic tool and work your way on the both edges. And this will allow you to remove the tool. Now, keep in mind how those are connected, because they are quite similar and I think that you can actually accidentally swap them over. So remember which one is on which end. I would recommend maybe to take the photo on this stage just to make sure that you're doing this right. On my, you know, radio, I can see that the darker one is on the right side and then the silver one is on the left side. So this will be how I would remember it. Now, to disconnect this, same as before, you're pressing this wee button, if you can see it, on the middle, and this will allow you to disconnect the connector, same as here. You're pressing the middle one and this will go above. Now the next step, you have to open the drawer, so you're pressing this button, it's opening. Then you're placing your tool here on the top, you see there is a clip. So you're placing your plastic tool and you're pushing this out. Then you're doing the same thing on the bottom and pushing it out here as well. You're starting from the top. They are also bottom holders. Now you see when it's open, you can now gently push it. Maybe not push it, but you can work your way out and then you can push it. You see, without damaging it. If you will not open the drawer, you got high chance of damaging it. So be sure first to open it. You see there is another holder here and another one on the bottom. So this is what holds this part. Now when this is removed, you have to disconnect connectors on this end. One is here, and again, this is just a matter of pulling it out. And then another one is for those buttons, and it's there. So when this is disconnected, then this part will come off. So the next step will be to remove those two screws, and this will release DVD. So, or CD, whatever you have. So this one and that one. So now we can see that the DVD is removed. Now we have to disconnect four connectors. So the first one is located here. You see, this is the first one. So you're pressing this wee thing and this will allow you to disconnect this. So the first connector is gone. The second one, let's say the big one, you have to squeeze it and this will allow you to lift this up and it will come off. So let me show you how it looks like. And you see this, this is what I pressed. So it's locking, you have to press it and then you can release it up. Next one is this, oh, too many cables. This one and the final one is that one. So first you have to remove the top one and then the bottom one. I think this is, again, you have to squeeze it on the top and it will come off. So the first thing which I always do is to place everything what I have on the second seat, because then I can see what I have to connect. What I'm always doing is first installing all the cables which go to the radio. So everything it's pointed here, because it's hard if you will first install the radio and then you will try to route the cables. So first I'm installing the cables. So I will start from GPS antenna. And as I mentioned before, I will install this antenna over there just to avoid putting too many cables close to the airbag pillar. So this is how it looks like. So the antenna is located here. So when you're gonna drive, it's not gonna interfere with your vision or anything. Also, it doesn't go next to the airbag, which is good. The minus is that there is a blower heater which actually might warm up the glue, but I was trying to put this as far as I can away from it, so I'm hoping that this will be enough. Yeah, then what you're doing is you're taking the plastic tool, you're squeezing the wire so it's gonna go through in. Now when the antenna went through up to this point, what we're gonna do is remove this screw, that screw, and the one on other side as well. This will help to drop it down so we can put the wire below and get this to the radio.
Now with those screws gone, you can see that they are also clips here. So you're pulling them down and this will allow you to put the wire over there and then just access the radio chamber, which is there.
Now what I would recommend to do, I know this looks weird, but it's not easy to get the cable here. So I would recommend to use one of those, holders for wires. Just wrap it up around the cable and just feed this in from here and grab it there. Because in other case, you can just cut yourself in number of places. But by doing this way, you can easily get the cable here. And remember, you're getting this to this point because this is the place where you got the radio. So now when the GPS antenna is here, that's good. We got this ready for being connected. I reuse the Wii cable, which I had for adding this to the stick, just to tie up the wires, just to make sure that you're not gonna create mess. Because in case if you would like to make any upgrades to it or change anything, then it's much easier to manage cables like that. So the next step, which I will do, will be connecting the Bluetooth microphone. Sadly, this radio is different from other one. I have longer cable, and this longer cable allowed me to connect to here. Sadly, this one doesn't. It's pretty short. So what I would recommend for your installation is buy extension cable, where you can actually just add the extension. For now, what I will do, I will install this somewhere here, I think, for now. So what I will do, it's I will drop this in. So I will do this other way around because this is much smaller. So I will drop this in, pull it out over here under the steering wheel. So I did manage to drop the mic over there. Then I was just moving it about so it will just go through and hit the ground. I pull it out from the bottom like here and then pull it in the Wii space over there, and I think the place where I will install this will be here, because when this will be lifted and the steering wheel is like that, it's not gonna really interfere with anything that I do, but it's still gonna be not far away from the driver. So in my case, this will be installed somewhere here. Now one more thing, if you will be installing this as I just did, then make sure the wire goes over there and is quite tight. Because in other case, when you will be using this dial, it might actually get in the way. But if this is over there, then there is no option that this will get in the way. So make sure it's going over there and it's quite tight. So currently we have antenna and microphone. The next, what I will add, will be the reverse camera. So one of the connectors, I will drop it down, put it out as previously, and then try to work this out to the back of the car. So as previously, I left myself so much of the cable hanging out. Everything else is already there. So this time I will start putting the screws and everything back. So because we're not gonna put anything more on this end. We will put USB connections, but they will go in this end because they will be installed in the glove box, at least in my case. You can do something else if you like, but in my case, they will be on this end. So this end is done for myself. So I put the cable to this point where it merged with the GPS antenna. Then inside of the seal, you see it's here, it went here. Now, this is just a matter of removing the clamps. So just pushing this out, and this will allow you to push your connector further, which will go to this point. Now, as you can see, this is under the seal, so nothing is hanging out. Then here, I am pushing this out, and again, I will put the cable below, and I will transfer this to the back seats. So the cable has been moved through there, under this. Then I leave the seat. It's just a matter of pulling it out. Then the cable went again here, and then I squeeze this here. Now, to get this properly, you have to unlock the couch, which is here. You have to put the screwdriver here, try to move it about, and then you can push this further, and this will allow you to move the connector for rear view camera. Now when this side is done, we are moving to the other side. So on this end, we're gonna have the USB connectors. So what I've done, I push the USB connectors into the V-hole over here. Then I removed the screws, which is this one. There is one over there and one somewhere here. Yeah, over here. And this allow me to drop down the glove box. Now I use my stick just to push the cable all the way through, so it came out on the other end. Then on other end, I've managed to pull it above the CD changer. So this is how I got those. If you will have not enough space by removing only those six screws, then you will need to remove the screws under as well. And this will allow you to drop it down lower, and then it will be easier for you to go through. With me, I did manage to do this because, you know, I got like specialized tool. I'm joking, of course. But yeah, I did manage to do this by just pushing it through. So in my case, that was enough. Now I'm gonna put this back together because those two cables, they are the only one that I will have in the glove box. Now when we have everything put back together, there is a USB connector, the GPS antenna, reverse camera, microphone. We can now start to connect things together. I noticed that there is something new to this radio. I haven't seen that before. It looks like some kind of speaker. I'm not very sure. For now, I think I will not connect this. I will just disconnect the connector and then wrap the cable. It's quite long as well. So this one bit I will skip, but I will definitely add the information. What is it? To me, I think this is kind of speaker, but I'm not really sure why there is a speaker. Anyway, what we're gonna do now, this is an original connector. This radio have the CD changer, which goes by optical connection. So we need to disconnect this from original socket, because the replacement one, the new one, doesn't have any connector here. There is just a blinder, which means that if we'll connect this way, the signal will not go into the radio at all. So we have to disconnect this from this connector and connect this in the same position to the new connector. Now to disconnect the CD changer fiber optic cable, you have to push the connector in. I will disconnect this. This, you see, you have to push this in, and this will allow you to release the connector. So now when you have this connected, I will push this in because you don't really need it. This will be the one which you're gonna work on. You can see also that there is an auxiliary connected already, which is brilliant. And then the other end, which goes for reverse camera and also reverse camera inspection, or I think this is power for reverse camera. Then this, I will put this in and I will put it out over here, because this will go to my reverse camera connector, which is located here. So now with everything connected, we need to test the radio and also test the camera, because camera can operate in two ways. One, where the power is supplied by the radio, so this is this camera plus, then the reverse view on the radio is switched automatically, or the second type is where there is a camera detection which recognizes the power from the reverse camera, which means that you have to connect the camera, like back camera, to the reverse light, and when you switch the reverse gear, this will power on the camera, which will be recognized by the radio, and then radio will switch on to the reverse view. So first I will see if this will work with power from the radio. So this is gonna be plus connected to the plus from the camera, and also reverse camera view will be connected to just reverse camera. So now we are connecting mic. You can see there is a mic connector. There are also other connectors, but in this car we're not gonna use them. So it's video in, there's auxiliary in, there's like a, I think DVR, yes, this is a DVR. There's like a lot of connectors for another things which you can upgrade with the car, but for this car we're not gonna use it. So we're just gonna use the mic from this connector. I did connect it the rear view camera and also plus to the plus. I also connected, this is a fiber optic, which went to the left connector, as you look at it this way. You see, it's on the left one. So it's the same as it was there. And now I will connect all of this back to together. So first I will put the DVD, connect all of this to DVD because that's the easiest one. So just to give you a quick recap, the black connector goes here. The blue one, which looks similar, goes to the other side. You see it's there. So what I've done, first I connected the blue one, then I connected the silver one, then I connected this one, secure this up to the point when this part went down and I heard the click, and then I connected the last one. Now when everything is done, I will gently put this back to the proper place and secure this with the screws. So the DVD is back in place, as you can see. The next step will be to add this and connectors. Remember that on each side you got one connector. So guys, I just got an update from the seller regarding to this Wii speaker. So this Wii speaker works in the way where when you're driving and listen to the music and you're still using navigation, then all the commands from navigation going through the speaker. So I don't really know where to install the speaker because I don't know where to place it. This is quite big, so if you add this to the window, well, that's gonna be quite big. So I think this car has plenty of storage, so I will add the speaker for now over here. And this might be even beneficial because this might work as a tube, which might make the sound louder. So for now, the speaker will go here. So what I found is that this is actually built from the two parts. So by removing one screw, which is located on the top, you can push out the top part. Then, if you, I know this sounds weird, but if you got, if you add this to DVD, to the bottom of it, then you can just slide this in and the speaker will be inside. So this is what I will do. I just don't want to break any parts and everything. So by doing this way, I can always remove the speaker and this can always go back to original. So this is how it looks like when it's done. So as you can see, you got still place for storage and it's, I think it's enough, to be honest. And the speaker is located over there. So we didn't have to break anything and the wire just went easily. So I put the wire over here, went up, then again behind the vents and it went back to here. And then I connected this to original, the black and white wire, which is here. So now I'm gonna connect the radio and see if everything works. So now if you look on the back of the radio, there is this big silver connector which goes here. This is the one that we have to press on the middle to pull out. And there is also another one, but this one you're not gonna use. So from the top, one of the wires, keep in mind, you're not gonna find the location for it because you're not gonna use it. So then the green one is your GPS antenna. And then here you are connecting remaining all the cables which are there. And then we're gonna see if radio will start. So this is the rear view camera. So this is a minus, but I'm not really sure if we have to use the minus if the power is supplied from the camera itself. So I connected the video cable and then the plus, which goes from the plus from the front of the camera, and the minus for now I will leave and let's see. So radio works, that's good. You can see that you can see everything on it, so that's very good. Everything else is quite messy because I haven't finished yet, but let's test the camera. So let's see. Yes, so it does switch to the rear view mode, which means that we do not need to use the pin cable, which means that the red connection which we did here we can secure now because everything is fine. So what I will do now, we need to tie up everything here and after that we're gonna install the rear view camera. At least we know it works and everything is fine, so this is just a matter of tidying up everything and the installation is complete. So we are doing reverse steps, so now we're gonna connect this back. And remember, the silver one is on left side, the black one on the right side. And then two screws which will hold this on the top. And then this part is back in place. So to get access to the rear view camera, which is as a handle,
we have to remove all those pins. So we have to remove the inside first, which is like this inside part, and then the other one will come off, and we have to remove all of the pins which are located all over the place, including those. They are too hidden as well, so they have to go too. So when you get access to the inside of the boot, I will transfer the wire. It will be held by tie cables here, will go through over here, then reverse camera, the handle, how I've managed to remove it. You see there are two clips on the edges. So what I've done, I pushed the middle of it down and I did manage to pull it out like that. And then I disconnected original cable. Now, the handle had the same power connector, so nothing has to be cut. Everything it's installed perfectly. So as you can see, the camera is installed. Make sure that the seal is all the way through, because if you're not gonna push it to the end, this might cause some issues further on. So the connector for the handle was exactly the same as original one, which means that we didn't have to cut anything, so that's pretty good. So the camera is installed and the radio is also ready to use. So guys, this movie is quite similar to the previous one which I did for installing of the Android radio, but it's slightly different. There are a few things which has been upgraded. Like for example, the Android system here is 9.0, it's not 7.1 as previous one. Also, there is a additional speaker which is located here. The mic is located there, and also GPS antenna is over there. So with all those differences, I hope that I explained more than on the previous movie. I hope that this one was more clear. I hope this will be useful for you. If any one of you would like to install this radio, I will put the link to this radio on the description, so you can just buy the same one. There is also better version, which is 8-core. This one is 6-core processor, so there is one processor which is 4-core and another one which is 2-core, but you can also buy the version with the 8-core. And this one, I think the difference is that this one has 4G on it as well, so you can add the SIM card if you like. You got access to the old iDrive, as you can see, with all features that have been there, so it's pretty good. If you swipe top down, you got your Android. So I hope this movie was useful, and as always, I wish you a good day.